You cannot change nobody in a relationship. If you don't love that person for their intrinsic qualities, for their creative expression, for who they are, find somebody else. Do not get with someone and then try to change them and force them into a mold that makes you feel comfortable and that makes you feel fulfilled. The truth about trying to control people is anyone that wants to change you does not love who you are right now. They love the idea of who you could be for them. Because if they loved you for who you were, they wouldn't try to change you. If people are trying to change things about you that don't hurt you and don't hurt them, they don't like who you actually are. They may like how you look. They may like what you do for them, but they don't like who you are. So when people try to change things about you, how you dress, how you express yourself, who you're friends with, they don't actually like you. Right? And when you try to change people, you're actually doing yourself a disservice because these qualities don't disappear. They just lay dormant around you. When you're with a woman, and before y'all met, she used to wear dresses. Let's say, for example. And in the relationship, you know, the guy decided one day that he doesn't want his woman to wear dresses because it shows her body too much. He doesn't like the way her shape is exposed, and she gets too much attention when they go out in public. So he tells her, I don't want you to wear dresses anymore, right? But dresses were something that she loved to wear. It made her feel beautiful. It made her feel feminine. It made her feel sexy. It made her feel good about herself. You telling her not to wear dresses is not going to eliminate her desire to wear dresses. It's not going to eliminate how she feels when she wears a dress. She's just going to not wear dresses around you to keep the harmony in the relationship. She's going to tell little white lies around you just to keep harmony in the relationship. That part of her never actually goes away. It just lays dormant around you, and she brings that side out of her around people that make her feel comfortable, people that actually love her, like her close friends and her family. She may not wear that dress around you, but she's wearing it on that girl's trip. You don't want your partner to feel like they're in jail to be with you. You don't want your partner feeling like they're in relationship jail. You know how some people say they feel free after leaving a relationship? Why does relationships have to be jail? Why? Why can't we be free and abundant in the relationship? Why do we have to be in jail with each other and then feel free when we leave the relationship? If I can't be myself with my next partner, he's not going to be my partner. Because I know that he doesn't really love me for who I am. The biggest mistake that I ever made in my life was thinking that I had to change things about myself to be more feminine or to be more wifey-like. To appease a man that really couldn't do anything for me anyway. I was changing things about myself for companionship, for romance, for 50% of my rent. I was changing things about myself, things that I loved about myself, for companionship, romance, and 50% of my rent. And these qualities, the things that, you know, this person wanted me to change about myself, they didn't go away. I just didn't bring that side of me out around him. So do not do yourself the disservice of trying to change people, because they're not going to actually change. They're just going to morph themselves into this person or this image that you're trying to force them to be. And they're going to be playing a role around you. They're just acting. They're just acting. They're going to act one way around you. And when they're around people that actually love them, you're going to see them be a whole different person. And you're going to wonder to yourself, why is this person so different when they're around their family? You know, they're funnier, they're more loose, they're more this, they're more that. Yeah, because they feel comfortable with these people because they love them for who they are. They love them for who they are. Changing people does not do anything but hurt yourself. All right. I remember I was talking to this friend of mine, and he was saying how the girl that he was talking to was telling him that she used to be a tomboy in high school and she was a basketball player, and you know, that's how she grew up. And a lot of guys are so anti-masculine anything in women. So, you know, before guys are comfortable with their masculine and feminine energies, they hate women that have any type of tomboy or masculine qualities about them, because they just instantly become intimidated. So he said that the girl told him that she did basketball in high school and she was a tomboy. And he told me that he told her, you know, I don't want to hear about that. You know, I don't want to hear about that shit, you know, da da da. And I remember telling him, well, you are with this girl, so do you actually like her? You know, if she's telling you that that is a part of her and she felt comfortable enough to open up to you and share that side of her with you, why would you tell her, I don't want to hear about that? I mean, you're acting like she's like a man or something. Like, she just said that she used to play basketball and she was a tomboy. Why would you shoot her down when she's trying to open up and let you know who she is as a person? I don't want to hear that shit. I don't care if you was a tomboy. Da-da-da-da-da. I don't want to hear that masculine shit. So basically, you're letting her know that you don't like that side of her, right? So it's not like that side is just deleted out of history. That side is still in her. But now she's going to wear those basketball shorts around the house when you're not there. Now she's going to be interested in sports and basketball on TV when you're not there, because you already let her know that you don't like that side of her. When people try to change things about you, they don't love you. They don't love you, period. They love what they want to mold you into that fits their agenda. Being with someone that tried to change the way that I dress, the things that I posted, the people that I hung with, the things that I said online, it made me feel so claustrophobic. And I thought that me changing these things about myself was me proving my femininity to this guy. I thought that that was me proving that I was wifey material. I thought that that was me proving that I could be submissive to this guy. Oh yeah, I don't have to, you know, I don't have to wear the things that I want to wear. I don't have to dress how I really want to dress. I don't want to, I mean, I can change the things I post for you, you know, just to feel like I'm able to be submissive. Y'all, when I tell you, when I left that relationship, I literally felt free. I felt like I can finally be myself again. And I was nervous because it made me think, well, if he thought that I was, that I dressed too sexy or I was too this or too that, are other men gonna think that too? Months later, I met a guy that literally not only loved everything about me, but constantly reminds me over and over, I want to exalt you. I want you to be who you are. I love how you are. I love how you dress. And I'm not intimidated because I know you're with me. That's the type of reaffirming that I need. That's the type of encouragement. That's the type of support that I need. I don't need someone telling me that if you don't do this for me or do that for me, you're not feminine or you're not wifey material. What you mean? No, I'm just not for you. So, you know, coming across people that actually likes me, coming across a guy that actually liked everything about me, it showed me that you really don't have to settle out here. You really don't. You do not have to settle for someone that doesn't love you for you, 100% you. You do not have to settle for someone that makes you want to hide yourself around them just to keep harmony in their relationship. You do not have to settle for someone that you can only be 50% of yourself around just to avoid arguments or just to avoid him being insecure. There are men out here that will love you for who you are and wouldn't want to change a thing about you. Now, if you're toxic, okay, that's one thing, obviously. But if it's like intrinsic things about you, the pure divine things about you, there is someone out here that's going to love all of those qualities about you, and they're not going to make you change nothing about yourself to be with them or to be qualified or to be wifey material, right? Or to prove that you're submissive. So yeah, I'm not with the control. I'm not even the type to try to control my man. If I don't like you, if I don't like your behavior, if I don't like how you act, I'm just not going to be with you. I'm not going to try to change you and cause all this friction in their relationship because I'm trying to turn a cat into a dog. Why would I even waste my time? You know, so yes, you don't have to settle for someone that only likes 45% of you. You don't have to settle for that. And if someone is trying to control you, change you, and dictate how you move and how you dress and how you live life, that person does not love you. All right. So if you are not subscribed to my channel already, make sure you go ahead and do that. Turn on your notifications. I'll see y'all in the next video. And if y'all have any other topics y'all want me to elaborate on, comment them below. You're not finna control me. Fuck.